Fell.
Good afternoon, thanks for having me, Pat, good to see you, and I just wanted to say that I've been everywhere from Randolph down to the southeastern part of my district, to CD5, to CD3, and now here today. And the question is why? Well, a big part of it is just to say, first off, thank you, and secondly, there's hope. The fact of the matter is that I want you to know is that we are working tirelessly at the Capitol to do our best to take on a DFL legislature and governor that right now are absolutely out of control. You may recall that when we did the healthcare debate on the floor, we spent 12 hours introducing amendments, pointing out the flaws and the problems in this. And so I just wanted to come here and tell you that your legislators are doing the very best that we can to stop and slow down the bad things that are happening up there and at least point out to the public what is going on. The good news is in just over 18 months, there's another election.
Yeah.
And the fact of the matter is, we are going to need all of you. And I remember when I was first endorsed for the Senate back in February of 2010, the first word that came to my mind, and I told it to all my supporters, was humbled. That I'm very humbled to be there, and every day when I drive up to the Capitol, I realize that I'm there to be your servant. And without you on the ground, pounding signs, knocking on doors, writing us checks, getting lit sent out, we have no chance to move the conservative cause forward. And I'm telling you, there are some people who wonder if there's a significant difference between having the Democrats and the Republicans in control. I can tell you that in a year and a half, nobody will doubt that anymore. So please, let's do the best that we can to understand that Thomas Jefferson said the price of freedom is eternal vigilance. This is a marathon, it is not a sprint. And we took a very hard hit in November. And a part of the reason that I'm trying to get in front of as many people, good people like you, that believe in the conservative cause, is to tell you that there are folks in St. Paul doing the best that we can to fight this thing off and set ourselves up that hopefully with your help, we will have a Republican governor in January of 2015, we will have a Republican House of Representatives, and we'll have a Republican U.S. Senator replacing Al Franken. So just a big thank you. We appreciate your help and have a good day.